quiet yourselves for this morning's liturgy. This morning, I know many of you heard about the tragedy that has befallen one of our teachers, colleagues, mentors, and friends, Mr. Gannon. We want to, in a special way this morning, keep him in mind. We want to, in a special way, keep his family in mind throughout the course of this liturgy. I know here at Spelman, the liturgy and our house of prayer is so powerful, and today we look forward to being able to lift up both Mr. Gannon and his family and our family here at Spelman to heaven in a special way, and to lead us off this morning with a few words, I introduce Mr. Paul Kelly.
So Jesus assures us, where two or more believers are gathered in my name, there also will I be. So we look out there at all of you. I'm very confident that God is absolutely present and with us right here and now. And it's good that we're able to gather together with each other and for each other. We will, of course, offer this Mass up for Mr. Gannon and his family. For us as Catholics, being together in community, celebrating the Eucharist, is what we're called to do. We thought about changing up some of the music to make it more quiet and reflective, but then we thought Mr. Gannon would want us to celebrate with our typical, positive, upbeat Spelman style. And it's always, always appropriate to thank God and praise God all of our hearts and all of our energy. So we will use this liturgy as the perfect opportunity to give God glory, even in the midst of all this sadness, to offer up our prayers, of course, for the Gannon family. One of the songs that we'll be singing, we're prepared to sing an offertory, is called I Can Only Imagine. And the words talk about what it will be like when we die and when we go to heaven, at that moment when we see the very face of God for the first time. It will be the greatest moment in our lives. So Josh and the choir will be singing these words. I can only imagine what it will be like when my eyes see your face before me. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus? Or will I be in awe and be still? Will I stand up in your presence? Or to my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak at all? I can only imagine. So in the midst of this tragedy, there is great joy for Officer Sean Gannon, for he, at this very moment, is gazing on the face of God. So our song today at Offertory will be a prayer for Officer Sean, and for the Gannon family, and for all of us, as we strive to live a life on earth worthy of an eternal life in heaven when our time comes. And we should say, I can only imagine what that will be like. And lastly, we ask for your additional prayers for our missionaries who will be traveling to Jamaica over this April vacation to serve those in need. This is an amazing opportunity for 35 of our students, accompanied by Mrs. Duramo, Ms. Collins, Ms. Choate, Mrs. Demers, and Mrs. Hurley, our nurse. We're so grateful to them for their service, and we pray that their mission trip will both be safe and life-changing. So here we go. Let us begin. We are still in the midst of the Easter season. It's a season of joy, and more importantly today, a season of hope. So in spite of all the challenges that we face, our faith gives us the courage and the perseverance to trust that God's promise is always that he will always be with us. So we are gathered indeed in his name. Let us celebrate well. I'm going to ask Adelina to come on up and sort of set the stage for the theme of this liturgy in addition to being offered up for the Gannons.
Supper is on me, says Jesus. Our Lord and Savior has come to feed us. Two fish and five loaves, how they are multiplied, no one knows. A miracle by Jesus, that's how it goes. The apostles worried, and as they passed the loaves, their fears buried. With 12 baskets of scraps, hand over your fears to Jesus and relax. Good morning, administration, faculty, staff, students, and LTS. In today's gospel, we hear of Jesus performing a massive miracle. With a crowd of 5,000 people listening to him preach, the apostles were fearful they would not be able to feed everyone. With just two fish and five loaves, They brought that fare to Jesus, and he fed all 5,000 with 12 baskets of scraps left over. What would happen if we brought our fear, our failures, our anxiety to him? Would he not do the same for us? Thanks to Deacon Joe and the Divine Mercy image in prayer posse who taught us about the Divine Mercy chaplet in adoration this week, we know that answer. Jesus, we do trust in you.
And we're ready to begin. Our opening song is called Awesome God. I think you know it. Hopefully you do. Please stand and join with us. Welcome, Father Rick, if I'm so good, singing our opening song.
As we begin our worship this morning, let's recognize that we too are called to speak for Christ. Let's ask God for courage. Let's ask God for wisdom. Let's ask God for mercy. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You were seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Hail Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, that we may withstand the trials of this world with invincible firmness of purpose, just as you did not allow your martyr, Pope St. Martin I, to be daunted by threats or broken by suffering. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. A Pharisee of the Sanhedrin named Gamaliel, a teacher of the law, respected by all the people, stood up, ordered the apostles to be put outside for a short time, and said to the Sanhedrin, "Fellow children of Israel, be careful what you are about to do to these men. Some time ago, Theudas appeared, claiming to be someone important, and about 400 men joined him, but he was killed. And all those who were loyal to him were disbanded and came to nothing. After him, Judas the Galilean, at the time of the census, he also drew people after him. But he too perished, and all were too loyal to him were scattered. So now I tell you, have nothing to do with these men and let them go. For if this endeavor or this activity is of human origin, it will destroy itself. But if it comes from God, you will not be able to destroy them. You may even find yourselves fighting against God." They were persuaded by him. After recalling the apostles, they had flogged him, ordered them to stop speaking in the name of Jesus, and dismissed them. So they left the presence of the Sanhedrin, rejoicing that they had been found worthy to suffer dishonor for the sake of the name. And all day long, both at the temple and in their homes, they did not stop teaching and proclaiming the Christ Jesus, the word of the Lord.
Jesus went up on the mountain, and there he sat down with his disciples. The Jewish feast of Passover was near.
When Jesus raised his eyes and saw that a large crowd was coming to him, he said to Philip, "Where can we buy enough food for them to eat?" He said this to test him, because he knew himself what he was going to do. Philip answered him, 200 days' wages worth of food would not be enough for each of them to have a little. One of his disciples, Andrew, the brother of Simon Peter, said to him, "There is a boy here who has 5 barley loaves and 2 fish. But what good are these for so many?" Jesus said, "Have the people be reclined." Now there was a great deal of grass in that place, so the men reclined about 5,000 in number. Then Jesus took the loaves, gave thanks, and distributed them to those who were reclining, and also as much of the fish as they wanted. When they had had their fill, he said to the disciples, "Gather the fragments left over, so that nothing would be wasted." So they collected them and filled 12 wicker baskets with fragments from the 5 barley loaves that had been more than enough to eat. When the people saw the sign he had done, they said, "This is truly the prophet, the one who is coming into the world." Since Jesus knew that they were going to come and carry him off to make him king, he withdrew again to the mountain alone. The Gospel of the Lord. The story of the little boy. He was at the shore. And on this particular beach, there were hundreds and hundreds of starfish seemingly stranded on the shore. And this little boy would pick up a few of them into his hand, then step into the water and drop a few into the water. And he'd go back and do it again. There was this old man who saw the little boy doing this and was watching him over and over again, dropping these starfish into the sea. And he finally came up to the little boy and he said, "You know, what you doing? Look how many starfish there are here. Do you think you're really making a difference by doing this?" The little boy kept on picking them up and tossing them, and he goes, "You made a difference to that one." In our lives, there are always people who are naysayers. People around us who put us down, insult us, don't listen, dismiss our ideas. Sadly, it goes on throughout life. I know it in my own life. But we can't let those naysayers win. We do. We close in on ourselves. We don't recognize our own goodness. We become even more insecure. I believe that we cannot allow those people to silence us. In the first reading, the Acts of the Apostles, those fearless, now fearless because of the Holy Spirit, fearless apostles, they didn't let anyone get in the way of their witnessing to Christ. They got called in and they were told to be silent. "Don't use the name Jesus." And Peter said to them, "We need to be accountable to God, not to you." And they went out and kept on speaking of Jesus. And in today's reading, they were brought in, but then the Sanhedrin didn't know what to do with them. And one of the men, as you heard, he says, "You know, this could just last for a short time. Let's ignore them." But then after they decided that's what they'll do, they brought them in and had them beat. But the apostles gathered together afterwards, and they were joyful because they had the privilege to suffer for Christ. We celebrate this feast of St. Martin. He too suffered for Christ. He didn't let anyone silence him, even though the emperor had shipped him off into exile. He He wasn't afraid. He knew that he had to speak about Christ. And that's what we're all called to do, to discover our voice, not to be afraid to witness for Jesus. I think what makes it easier to do that is once you know that you are loved, once you know that you're loved by God. When I speak about love from God, I'm speaking about unconditional love. And I didn't always have that. I grew up believing that God loved me, but it was a conditional love. I'll love you when you do all the right things, but then I'll be really ticked off at you when you do something wrong. So even though I was already ordained a priest, I did not have that close relationship with God. Sounds crazy, but it's true. Finally, 15 years into my priesthood, I was at a very special place with me called Medjugorje. And a friend of mine had died a few months before that, and I was devastated. And so I was in this place in prayer, and I heard these words, "When are you going to let me love you?" And I literally looked and turned around to try to see who is it that's speaking to me. And I realized it was my Heavenly Father. And I answered him that day and said, "I guess I'll start today." And my life changed from that moment on. I came to believe that God loves me no matter what, unconditionally. I don't have to do another right thing, and I will always be loved by God. And once you have that as a foundation, you do become confident. And then you understand that Jesus is the great gift that the Father who loves me, gave to me, gave to you. And there's a joy that comes from that when you realize that Jesus is your gift. And then you live differently. You live with confidence, and you don't let anyone silence you. And you give who you are. You share your talents. You don't let anyone silence you. In today's gospel, you have the story of a boy with 5 barley loaves and a couple of fish. And the apostles thought, "We got 5,000 people here. What's the good of that?" But you know, that boy offered what he had, and he put it in the hands of Jesus. And Jesus did something miraculous with it. And that's a life lesson for all of us. Because we can think about, what do I have? What can I give? What talents do I have? If we put them out there, if we offer them to Christ, he can use those in amazing ways. All we have to do is offer it. Give it to the Lord, and the Lord will do incredible things. I know a little bit later on this morning, at this Mass, we're going to pray for those who are going on mission. They're taking their talents, they're bringing their talents to Jamaica, they're witnessing for Christ. That's what it means to be alive in faith. But for those of you who can't get to Jamaica, those of you who can't do a missionary trip, every day is an opportunity to put yourself out there, to speak your words, words of compassion and love, to share your faith with those you encounter. That's what it means to be alive. So I hope you pray this morning that every one of you here truly believes that you are loved. And you are loved by God as you are. I've got lots of nieces and nephews, 19 nieces and nephews, 21 grandnieces and nephews. And when one of them was born a couple of years ago, I went into a religious goods store to buy something, and the plaque said, "The Lord danced the day you were born." And I believe that. I believe the Lord dances a lot.
When you were born, the Lord gave, because you are his precious daughter or son. And I want you to believe that. And I don't want anyone to take that away from you. You are precious to God. You are good. You are worthy. You are loved by this community as well. That's why I'm so honored and privileged to be with you this morning. Because I believe that this is a great environment for you. Because this school is not afraid to talk about Jesus Christ. This school is not afraid to let you know that you are loved by God. It is all good. Let's pray this morning for those who are going on mission. Let's pray that every one of us here will not be afraid to use our voice to witness Jesus Christ. Can we stand now and lift up our hearts in prayer? Heavenly Father, we give over to you now our worries and our needs. We ask that you hear these prayers and give answer.
We pray for continued guidance of the Spirit for our church leaders and the leaders of our community. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray that we here at Cardinal Spelman will always feel Christ's hand in ours, leading us along our journey. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray that we not lose heart when we meet obstacles along our path, but instead will cling to our faith with bold conviction. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our missionaries traveling to Jamaica. May their service make a difference in the lives of many, protect them, and return to us safely. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear
our prayer.
We pray for the gift of humor and joy that allows Jesus to see the glory of the kingdom dawning amid the difficult days of his human journey. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our loved ones who are sick at this time and for those who have recently passed on to eternal life. We remember in a special way Sean Gannon, Mr. Gannon's brother, who tragically lost his life last night. May the peace and the presence of God bring comfort to the Gannon family. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, we thank you. Thank you for listening to us. Thank you for loving us as we are. As we go forth, may we trust in you completely and trust in your holy will. We ask this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Right now, my sisters and brothers that are sacrificed may be acceptable to God. They are all my fathers. You know, God accept the sacrifice at your hands. For the praise of the Lord. As we commemorate the martyrdom of St. Martin, we make our offering at this altar, praying that we, who celebrate the mysteries of our Lord's Passion, may imitate what we now do through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Lift up your hearts. We lift the hearts of the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty, our salvation. At all times we acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to the Lord you get more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly banquet are thrown open to the faithful. For death is our ransom from death, and in his rising, the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land and people exults in your praise. Even the heavenly powers with angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. He took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring it to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Sean, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. All who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, St. Joseph, her spouse, the apostles, the martyrs, St. Mark, all the saints who pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. We praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Trusting now in God's perfect, unconditional love for us, let us now pray as Jesus has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us all our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ, for the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, but not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will. We live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you and with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Thank you.
Missionary committees had come up with at the very beginning that we never really focus on in one of our prep meetings was the theme of because he loved me first. In your homily today, pretty much just summed up everything that theme would be about and is about as we set up upon this mission trip. And so the missionaries that were listening to that homily today, that is that commissioning to that in order to do the work that we do, that you will do, we have to know and believe that God has loved you first, and then to bring that love to the people that we meet in Jamaica. The second thing that struck me this morning as I was talking to Mr. Donovan before school was, he said to me, for the next 7 days, your group can do good, and our world surely needs good things to be done. And that really affected me this morning, and has struck a chord that I just share with you, because to be able to be in Jamaica, and to know that we're in Jamaica while the Gannon family will be putting their brother to rest, I think the best way to be able to honor that in our own way is to do good and bring good into the world. And our way for doing that immediately is the residents of Jamaica will also bring good into our lives too. And so, as the missionaries come forward in a moment, to the students here, to know that they represent you. We always say that some give by going, and these are them, but others go by giving, and that is you. That the coin wars, the donation drive, the support of you, as well as so many people, over 700 people, have either donated or committed to praying for this trip. And so the people that come forward for that blessing and commissioning represent all those people who have given so much to make this happen as well. And to know that we represent you, that the good that we will do next week, that we hope that we are able to do in just a small way, is representative of you. And that we carry all of you with us to this mission trip, and that we hope that whether you are able to go during your years here at Spelman or beyond, that this is a moment that you can think into your minds, how can I do good here locally, here in my homes, here in my country, in the world? And that's our call, that we sometimes have to go to a third world nation to realize that my call really is to serve the person that's living in my home. And sometimes that happens, and we can come back home and realize that. And so to you, we thank you for your support. And at this time, I'd like to call up forward all the missionaries, the students and teachers, to come forward to the stage for a blessing for our mission trip to Jamaica.
Stand and everybody raise your right hand towards the missionaries. We're going to ask God's blessing that the Spirit of God falls upon them and that they go there with fires in their hearts for the people of Jamaica.
Lord Jesus, we praise and thank you for the gift of faith that you have given to these young women and men. We thank you for the desire that is in their hearts to give of themselves generously. We ask that you bless their journey, bless their interactions as they are on mission. Help them to know that what they are doing is holy and important, and they will touch lives, and their lives will be changed. We praise you, Lord, for the generous spirit that you've given to these women and men. And we ask that you go forth with them, that your spirit may guide and direct them, and that when they return home safely, they may be full of gratitude because you, Lord, have allowed them to be your instrument, that they have done your holy work. We ask that you bless them with confidence, with joy, with peace, Bless their families so that they are not anxious or worried. Help their families to trust that your hand will be upon them, now and all the time that they are away from them. We ask that you bless these friends. Help them to go forth in your name, in your joy, and in your peace. And may Almighty God bless each and every one of you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit.
Amen. Before the final blessing, I'd like to thank Father for being with us.
Ask all of you to please join with me. Let's pray for Deacon Joe. He's always praying over other people. Let's pray for him, for healing for him, okay? So we can extend our hands and ask God to bless him. Lord, I praise and thank you for the gift of faith, the gift of love, and the gift of service that you've given to this holy man. We ask that you bless Deacon Joe. I ask that you give him courage, determination, strength, and peace. We ask you, Lord, to also bring about a healing for him, because he desires that. We desire it for him. He needs that so he can continue to do his holy work. So bless Deacon Joe. Bless and heal him. Give him your strength, your peace, and your joy. May Almighty God bless you, Deacon Joe, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen. Thank you all.
Just for the missionaries, be sure to pick up your t-shirt before you leave school today, if you can. Thank you.
Please stand.
Peace, to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.